along with a water bottle filling stations, which you should still be voting on in the corner of your screen, there's something else new to campus, and that's advisory.
Advisory replaced Alpha. Let's see what Alina and Emily have to say about the upcoming class this year.
You can talk about the lessons that we get to learn with our friends and learn different things.
Hi, I'm Alexis Lyle, and I am a sophomore, and I don't like advisory because I wish we had a study hall to do our homework and get stuff done.
Hi, I'm Anna. I preferred last year advisory better because it was more of a study hall, and especially as a junior, I think it's more important that we do better and we have more time to focus on our grades than to get speeches that I think a lot of people don't like tend to listen to or participate in.
Hi, I'm Cameron Shepherd, and I'm a senior, and I liked that we watched Friday Night Lights in advisory because I can pretty much quote that whole TV show. But besides that, I prefer the advisory from last year because I could get my work done and talk to my friends.
Hi, my name is Mrs. Rosen, and I have a freshman advisory group. And I really love them because it gives me such a great opportunity to form personal connections with my freshmen that I'll have for the next 4 years in advisory. And I also really enjoy watching the Mustang Mentor presentations. They are really amazing.
I like the idea of advisory. I don't like the candor responses and the lesson plans that they've provided for us.
Now to the most important part of our broadcast, football.
That's debatable, Denver. School spirit is important too.
I'm Nick Obar, junior.
What position do you play, Nick?
Defensive end. We're doing pretty well this year. We're going to lose some good seniors next year, but I think we'll be strong too next year also.
What do you think your chances are of making it to the playoffs?
I think we have a good chance. We have a lot of people that want to play, and we have good intensity in practice. So if we keep that going, I think we'll be in good shape.
All right. What's your favorite thing about Memorial football?
My favorite thing is definitely the intensity of the practices. I like being able to go out and hit people and having fun like with my friends. It's just a great, you know, intensity all around.
Who's your favorite coach?
Head coach Gary Koch all the way.
All right.
Hi, my name is Jackson Phipps. I'm number 72 for the right offensive tackle.
Are y'all more of a running team or a passing team?
Definitely more of a running team.
Has that worked well?
It's worked very well. Each game we've averaged over 200 yards. Last game against Aldine Davies, we averaged 4 yards a carry.
What do y'all think your chances of going to the playoffs this year?
I think it's very good.
And how far do you think you're going to go?
At least as far as last year, maybe a little bit more.
All right.
Debate is love. Debate is live.
It has a bunch of fine arts performing, such as impromptu, dramatic interpretation, and oratory.
Debate to me is actually something that is not a good thing.
Humorous interpretation, domestic extent, maybe foreign extent.
I believe that debate should be a fine art.
I actually do think debate should be considered a fine art for the following reasons. First, it really prepares you for the real world, like many fine arts do. For example, if you take into account like the oratory part of debate, which is not really considered very much, it's quite like theater. We speak in public, we speak very dramatically in duo interp, and then you speak with many different people, you can speak with two people, you're presenting to an audience. There's just so many aspects of debate that are not considered really.
Duo acting. That's pretty much it.
Go Mustangs!
Go Mustangs!
Go Mustangs!
Go Mustangs!
I'm Madeline Hamilton and I'm Mustang Sally. I think that our school spirit's pretty good. We have a lot of people dressing up for the pep rallies, and that always makes it more fun.
We definitely want to see more people at the games because it's more fun when we're cheering with the crowds, I guess.
Go Mustangs!
The more flat out awesome.
Go Mustangs!
My name's Will Davidson.
I'm Jake Steen, Dean Vaughn. And well, school spirit is great around Memorial. As many of you know, I'm the lead head number one MC at the Pep Rallies, so I have a ton of school spirit. Go Mustangs.
And me and Will are part of the Beecher Bombs.
Yeah.
You might see us with our hard hats on.
Yeah. I mean, the beautiful thing about Memorial is that there's so many different groups, you know. And it's so diverse here. I mean, they talked about the Bleacher Bums. I mean, they're some of the most ethical, caring, and just beautiful human beings at this school. And then you have groups like the Marquettes, and you have the band, and you have the Color Guard, and there's just so many groups. It just makes up such a great culture and environment at Memorial High School.
We also got our juniors. They all love to come support the games too. Steven Jekovic, Jack Nance, Burton Chonky, they're all great supporters of the games too.
Burton's he loves to cheer on our Mustangs.
Go Mustangs!
MHS rocks!
Just rocks.
Hey Memorial, I'm Hudson Lorfing. I'm your student body president. About school spirit, I think that we have some pretty awesome school spirit going on. We definitely can get a little bit better going to the football games and coming out to some sporting events.
Hi, my name's Dan Fricks, and I'm a Wrangler. I think the school has great school spirit, and a lot of our spirit groups really help, you know, boost school spirit and for events like homecoming, and we have a great turnout for all the football games. A lot of students go. It's really great.
My favorite pep rally would be the neon pep rally.
Neon, because I like all the lights.
The neon pep rally.
The temperatures are dropping.
But fall fashion is just heating up.
Hey Memorial, we're here with Arabella Benavides, and she's going to talk to us about fall fashion. So Arabella, what are some upcoming trends for fall this year?
I definitely see a lot of grays and neutrals coming up in the fall, and big comfy sweaters and boots. You know, comfy. Murder business, I can hold you down like I'm
giving lessons in physics. Right. You should want a bad.
Hi Memorial, I'm Mason Meredith, here with James Kirkpatrick. So with fall already here, what are some fashion tips that you want to give us?
Darker colors, some jeans, boots. Just be ready for the October season.
I'm so fancy. You already know.
I'm Kaylee, I'm a sophomore, and my favorite thing about fall fashion is flash tats.
Flash tats are really great for ACL and for parties that you don't want to wear jewelry to, and they're fall colors.
Lily, fall fashion, word on the street is you have a pretty good prediction of like what's to come. So can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, for sure. My prediction is cargo pants are coming back in style because you can show up to school in pants and you can zip off the knee and end school in shorts.
Some things I like wearing in the fall are flannels and short boots.
When it's cold, I like to wear Patagonias and polo sweaters.
In the fall, I like to wear big hoodies and Lulu leggings. You can always add in a choker.
It's October, and it's time for the dance.
It's homecoming, witches.
Butterflies when he says my name.
Hi, my name is Denver Fessmeyer, and this is Underneath the Fern. Today we're here with Johnny Hurelli. Hi, Johnny.
Hey.
Johnny plays basketball for the MHS Mustangs on the varsity's team.
Yes, sir.
So, Johnny, what are some exciting things about playing the least interesting sports in all sports?
Well, we are a predominantly Caucasian team.
That probably hurts you a lot,
yes.
Other teams are probably better than you.
No, just typically more athletic.
So it says here you play point guard. What's exactly the point?
It's much like being a male cheerleader, which I'm sure you're very fond of. You kind of direct the traffic as you do at the pep rallies, and the cheerleaders being a male.
Well, we're not necessarily cheerleaders, we're MCs.
Not
so. Jake might be a male cheerleader, but I'm an MC.
And male cheerleader.
So, Johnny, if there's one thing I know about you, it's that you're very uncomfortable with the shape of your body. So is it kind of hard for you to wear jerseys that resemble tank tops?
Is it difficult for you to be an Oompa Loompa for Willy Wonka?
So the movie I was in question talking about is White Man Can't Jump. Is that very true?
Judging from our vertical leap measurements, that is, yes, very accurate.
So how do you think that your squad, per se, this year would shape up against the MHS women's team?
Well, I would ask you the same question, but you are on the women's team.
Here, buddy, I'm going to kick you in the esophagus. I'm gonna eat your cuticles. Look, I invite you on my show when you treat me like this. It's very embarrassing. I'm taking the fern.
And that's it for October.
Thanks for joining us. And once again, from NBC Horsepower Drives the News, I'm Denver Fessmeyer.
And I'm Lily Austin.
See you in November.